Hello everyone, welcome back to the Hunter Training Garage. Today we're going to take a look at an awesome WinAlign feature called jacking compensation. With the popularity of longer wheelbase vehicles and longer delivery vans such as this one we have here today, in some cases you may have a vehicle that comes into your shop that doesn't allow for rolling compensation to get measurements on that vehicle's alignment condition. Jacking compensation is a great feature that allows you to still align those vehicles using a Hunter lift rack and the jacking technology we have on our RX and 4-post series lift racks. So we've pulled in our delivery van like we normally would, setting it up for rolling compensation, stopping just short of the turn plates. Now in that condition, as you can see when we try to place our wheel chocks, this provides an unsafe condition where our wheel chock is sitting here on our wheel stop. In this case, we would not want to try to lift this van as it would defeat the safety purpose of our wheel stops here on the back end of the rack. So the simple solution for our problem we have here today, instead of stopping short of the turn plates like we normally would for rolling compensation, we're going to pull the vehicle all the way forward until that front axle is centered on our turn plates. The benefit of this setup is that it allows us to use jacking compensation to still measure our vehicle. But more importantly, it allows the safeties and the wheel stops on the back of the rack to serve their purpose. So on longer wheelbase vehicles, using the wheel chocks on the front axle before raising the lift is okay. We can place our wheel chocks here on the front axle prior to raising the lift to keep the vehicle secure. So now that we have our targets mounted on our vehicle, we're going to set the aligner up to use jacking compensation. Now most aligners are going to default to rolling compensation, so to select jacking compensation, we're going to click K2 on our soft key menu to bring up our instructions for jacking compensation, and the aligner is going to ask us to jack up the wheels to be compensated and also remind us to mount the wheel targets if we've not already done so. So let's go ahead and jack up our axles. So now that we've compensated our four wheel targets and unlocked our turn plates, we're going to lower the vehicle and jounce the suspension to relax everything. From there, this is a normal alignment.